Australian Grand Final, Andrew Frawley to meet Ian Bradford from Melbourne. Bradford, 32 years of age, he's a manufacturing planner with Kodak Australasia. He's been bowling for 19 years, second in the 88 World Cup and a two-time winner of the South Pacific Classic. And he's registered the perfect 300 score on no less than six occasions. Andrew made it eight strikes in a row with his first ball of the final. And Ian was immediately under pressure when his first left two pins standing. Andrew extended his consecutive strikes over the two games to 12. And by the time he left pins standing in the eighth frame, he'd gone to a 158 to 133 lead. Bradford recovered for a total of six strikes in the game, but he couldn't overtake his opponent, who won 235 to 202. The ripper charge thus became sudden death for both bowlers. A cutthroat battle to become Asian zone champion for 1992.
Ian Bradford has the chance here to seize the initiative early on.
Well, as Ian knows, this is the business, all down to business. There's Sue anxiously watching. Now Andrew, well, he's just got to put it all together for this game, but he's bowling very well. He's shot 491 for the two games, averaging 245. Let's see where he can start out with.
Important here that he replies in kind.
There's that big shot again. He's still got it going.
It's an all-Australian final in the Asian Masters for 1992 at the Craigie Bowl in Perth. And this man from Sydney, Andrew Frawley, a detective, has really turned in some scintillating bowling. One stage, putting together a run of 12 strikes in a row.
Well, I've just worked it out. He's struck 17 times in 22 shots.
Quite astounding. But he's got big problems here.
He's got very big problems. This is exactly what he didn't need. You see here, the ball just goes straight through the middle. There's a horrible split. Just got to get two.
Open frame.
Yep, just take two. If Ian can now get up and get two strikes, he can go a long way in front very early in the match. And there it is. This is what I mean. You can't give him an inch. You know, the advantage of being the top seed is that you can relax and lose the game to save yourself for the second game where the other guy's got to go for it. See, they're perfect strike. 10 in the pits, great shot.
Ian's been bowling for 19 years. And a treble to commence this game. Things just slipping away from him at the moment.
Well, he's come back. This is exactly what he needs to do. He has to now get up there and get a few strikes under his belt. He's got to let Ian know that he's not down and out and that he hasn't got the upper hand. As we've talked before, this is very mental. Taking a lot of time over his shots.
Very solid.
That's the one he wants.
Very much a lightweight at 67 kilograms. Four in a row.
Now you see him shaking his head there because you notice he put the ball down a little early, but the ball held, went down, still got the pocket. So he was quite pleased with that, but he still knows he didn't bowl as well as he wanted to. But gives him a big lead. He's 60 in the second. 32-pin lead after two frames.
Marvellous performance here by Ian Bradford.
But Andrew's sort of keeping him honest at this stage. If Andrew can keep striking, then Ian has to keep striking.
This is for four on the trot.
He's got it. See the look at his face there, ball a little high, but held. That's fine.
And on his follow through, he finished up on lane 13 there. He really rode that one home.
Sure did. But you see, Ian just stands there and looks and goes, yeah. You know, like,
no problems.
I got five in a row, you know, you're still behind me. Ian's just got to make good shots. He obviously learned from his first game. And he's not going to make any mistakes this game. I don't think so. As you could tell, you know, the shot over there on the last frame that he bowled, he put it down a little early, got away with the strike. That time he knew it, did the same thing, knew it wasn't going to get a strike. He knows his own game. You'll see here the ball not coming in as hard. Pin just goes around.
Well, oh. Drama.
I think I've got the mockers on him. I see he's not going to make any mistakes. I can't believe that.
That really was just a lapse in concentration.
Well, you can see in there just going, what the hell? Yeah, it's really a strange feeling. I know sort of bowling is not looked at it, but it is so much a mental game. I've been there a million times before, and you really start to believe that, hang on, maybe I'm not going to win this. Fate comes in, and you become a bit of a fatalist.
So suddenly things not going as this man would want, Ian Bradford. And Andrew Frawley, who's sitting patiently, he had his hands, indeed his face between his knees just a few moments ago, sensing that he's got an opportunity. Bradford makes sure of that one.
Yeah, on the shot before that, he pulled the ball a little inside his target. On the next shot, he threw it a bit wider. He was a bit lucky to not leave the 10 pin with that. But he knows what he's doing at this stage. You can see him there, he's just going through it over his mind and saying, yeah, I know what to do, I know what to do. But it's up to Andrew. Andrew must strike to put it straight back onto Ian. He's got to pressure Ian to get him into making mistakes.
So well, the tension really climbing.
Well, right now Ian's only 10 pins ahead in the sixth frame. If Andrew had a struck there, it would have been all square after being way behind 5 minutes ago. So that was why I said he really needs a strike. Got the spare. Good shot. He's just got to get strikes because you can't rely on Ian to not strike.
Just one point at this level. I'm just wondering about technique. It's from the foul line to the pins at 60 feet or nearly 20 metres, but where are the bowlers aiming for on the lane? Where are they looking for on the lane?
Well, they're both area bowlers. They both look about 20 or so feet down the lane or 30 feet down, looking for their break point. That's where they want the ball to go. They look out on the lane, maybe 30, even 35 feet, to where the ball's going to break, and that's where they want to project it to. Yeah.
About halfway?
Yeah.
Well, Andrew Frawley had his opportunity, didn't he? But he hasn't been able to quite grasp it.
No, I think you'll see there the ball just coming up behind the head pin and leaving the wash out, the 1-2-4-10, and he's now going to hit the head pin on the left and swing it out over, not push it over to the 10 pin to take it out. But he's used a third ball for this. He's got a special ball for this, maybe. And he's done
it. Yes. Well, that could even be a match winner. Who knows? Very difficult spare.
Well, it really can. Because, you know, if Ian doesn't get up here and strike, you'll see here he pushes the pin over, comes off the kickback, picks it up. Beautifully done.
So now Ian in the eighth frame.
If Ian strikes here, he'll be 14 pins up.
We're in the home straight.
And he does.
And he certainly got his head in front. The whips are cracking and Ian Bradford is giving plenty.
Well, at this stage, Ian's in a situation that if he can strike here, he virtually shuts out Andrew. You know, Andrew had to keep striking before. He needed that extra strike when he left the nine in the seventh frame to really get up with Ian, and he hasn't. But Ian's got to make this strike, and he knows it. That's it. As I said, this man's tough. He knows that's the key shot that he had to make. And, well, now for Andrew, it's a case of if you don't strike, it's over in every shot that he makes.
There's still a faint hope there, but...
Well, there is a faint hope, but he has to strike every shot. He knows it, but, and what's worse is that you know it. You stand up there and you know that you have to strike. Well, it's exactly what I was talking to you before. You can just do everything right and not get the result. That's basically all over. You can see a little smile there on Ian's face. He's looked at the score, worked it out. You see the ball comes in and just lose a solid 10.
Yes, emotions are kept fiercely under control by Ian Bradley, but you can see him saying, it's mine.
Exactly, exactly. You know, after the shocking 9 miss, I can't believe he did that. He's got to really feel now that, well, that was what I got away with. But in Andrew Frawley's defence, I actually would say Ian's probably never been beaten twice in a stepladder. No, it's really academic for Andrew at this stage. If he spares and strikes, he shoots to 10. Ian, if he doubles in the 10th, can shoot 250. And even at this pace now, he's shooting 230 pace. So the game's over. It's all Ian's. He bowled superbly in the doubles. And he's bowled superbly throughout the match.
And the crowd acknowledging young Andrew, who in turn acknowledges the 1992 Asian Masters champion Ian Bradford.
Yes, Andrew would be bitterly disappointed with that, but I'm sure with Australia running first and second in the event, gold and silver, they'll be very happy.
So he's strung together three in a row. And looking for two more to finish.
And there it is, as the pressure's off, Ian now just wants to put it away. He's going to give him a 250 game. That's superb. So this is what I said before, you know, with the game before, he's got the game, he knows he can lose it, so he just goes out there and works on his game, gets it right, says, okay, I'll get another one.
Well, when things go wrong, it's a matter of peaking when it really matters, and
exactly.
That was the case for Ian Bradford, the 1992 Asian Masters champion. Superb performance by this great competitor, tough competitor, against the younger Andrew Frawley, who really put together a purple patch. Yes, Ian Bradford following his 202 in the first game with a spectacular 255, and his opponent finishing with 199. Well, Ian, what were you feeling when Andrew was putting all those strikes together in the first game?
Well, he certainly was lined up, and coming onto the pair of lanes, it was a little more difficult for me to get lined up, and I didn't do very well early on in the game. But once I figured it out, I thought I had a pretty good chance in the second match.
Yes, you looked pretty mentally switched on for that second one.
Yes, until I missed that 10 pin, which was another silly error because I haven't missed any all week. But I guess after that, Andrew did leave a couple of openings and I jumped in.
I think I might nickname you the Undertaker. You were very cool and clinical about the way you went about that.
I guess that's my approach to the game. I am a little bit cool. I try to be calm and try not to get too worked up because it can result in you throwing the ball too hard or too soft at crucial moments.
And what does the victory mean to you?
It being my first Asian Zone Masters, it's certainly a great title. And although Andrew did take the pressure off by winning the first match, and because it is a team's event, it really was good to run 1-2.
Congratulations. And so there it is. Bong Ku Garcia wins her second Asian Masters, 20 years apart, and Ian Bradford his first at his very first attempt. Gordon Bray signing off from the Craigie Bowl.